Okay, let me do well, lesson number two here. Let me do some basic syntax of the COBOL language, continuing from lesson one, right? You remember we have basically an input file, which in the old days would be either a deck of punched cards or a magnetic tape, right? And we would have an output file, which would typically be either a magnetic tape or a printed report, right? So if the input was punch cards, it would be 80 characters. If it was magnetic tape, it would probably be more than 80 characters per record. Output file, if it was magnetic tape, it could be any number of characters. If it was a report, it would be 132 characters because there's 132 characters in your standard old printed continuous paper printer, right? And working storage section is where you define the variables that are being used in your program, right? So if it's a numeric field, it would be defined like this, right? If it was 8 digits, it would be defined like this, right? If it was 4 digits, you could define it like this, but usually you would define it like this. Some people used to define it like that, right? Some people used to define it like that. It's all the same thing. Same thing with characters. If it's a character, it's defined with an X. You could say XX for 2 characters, right? Or you could say X2 like this, or you could say X02, or you could say X002, right? Then there were also 77 meant that it was a single variable, a variable that stood alone by itself. There were also group variables. If it was a group variable, it would start with a 0, 1, like this. A group variable, right? A group variable meant it contained certain parts, and usually it would be defined like this. Say the first part was 2 characters, the second part was 1 character, and the third part was 3 characters, right? You could define it like that, right? Now the first number here had to be a 1. The second number had to be something greater than 1, but typically you would say 05, right? Also, typically, unless you were a really bad programmer, you would line up your picks like this so the next programmer could see where the picks were, right? In the really old days when people used to use punch cards, it was hard to line up the picks or line up any words because you couldn't see very well where you were punching the columns on the card punch machine. So some really old programs have things not aligned up, right? Which would mean that it would look something like that and like that, right? Now, see this group variable has 4 parts, right? And the fourth part could contain other parts itself, right? So you could say part 4a like this, right? And then you could say a part 4b like this. The names must begin with a letter, and the names must have a certain number of characters, you know, depending on which version of COBOL you're using. Since the name could be, I forget, 16 characters, something like that. Then later versions, it might be 32. The idea was supposed to be, unlike most languages, we don't like people to define variables that are one letter like this. This is considered bad because it doesn't mean anything to the next person who works on the program, right? The idea is to make a variable name that actually makes some sense so that the next person who's working on the program understands what it is, right? Now that sounds good in theory, but the problem is that most people don't know how to type. And since they don't know how to type, they tend to make names that are as short as possible, right? So people would make a name like P4C, right? Because that's fewer characters to type, right? So So that's what would used to happen. And because in the old days there were no programming standards, every programmer who worked on a program would use a different style of indentation, a different style of variable naming, and so on. And this is one of the things that makes COBOL programs so horrible to read. That's lesson number two. I don't want each particular lesson to be on for too long, so I'll stop here and I'll continue with lesson number three.